Hey, what's up, DJs? So right now it is Monday morning at 6:30 a.m. It is going to be an exciting next few days. I just got everything loaded up. Saturday after our wedding at the park place, we loaded up Jerry's vehicle because we are actually going to be taking Jerry's vehicle to Pennsylvania. I'm waiting on an insurance check in the mail so I can get some front end damage repaired on my van. And because I don't have a headlight, I don't have a blinker, we didn't feel it was a great idea to take my vehicle to Pennsylvania. Mechanically, I can make it, but without a headlight, it's a little bit sketchy. So we loaded up Jerry's vehicle. I just got everything I needed to head over there. I'm gonna head over to Jerry's house and we are gonna be driving to Farmington, Pennsylvania to Fernstone Retreat, which is gonna be insane. I mean, this is the farthest I've ever been away from home to do a wedding. I've got a couple things I wanna show you as far as redundancy that I've done. That Howie Darkstar was gracious enough to allow me to come on the DJ and TV chill room a couple weeks ago, and we had talked about traveling for an event like this. Let's get over to Jerry's house and let's hit the road. It's gonna be an exciting one. Let's go. I'll catch up with you guys in a bit. All right, we are now in Dundee, Monroe, Michigan, and we are stopping off here at Great Lakes Eatery Pub. Eatery and pub is what it is, to grab a bite to eat. And I'm pretty sure I know a DJ that left my area not too long ago that works over there. That is the Splash Water Park. So that's kind of cool. I'm still walking with my cane. Here's Mr. Jerry.
Hey, Jerry's here, man.
Hey, Jerry's got a cane too. We both got canes, man.
Pretty nice.
Oh man, his is fancy. Look at that. Man, I need to step up my cane game, man. He just had to bring it out to show me up.
He just had to bring it out to show you, man.
He's like, this is what a real cane looks like. You know, a little boy's toy.
I got one of those too.
Sad excuse of a cane. We are in Dundee, Monroe, Michigan. It is currently about 12:35. I'm gonna get some lunch and get back on the road. We just got finished eating lunch. Confirmation, a DJ I know does work over there. That is the Splash Water Park. And a DJ that actually kind of got me started with DJing came over and said hi. And we are about halfway to Pennsylvania. It's 500 miles or 547 miles, I think is what it said. And we have driven 250 miles. So we have about 200 and so miles or another 250 or so miles to go. And then we'll be in Pennsylvania. We got Andrew Miller!
Yeah!
This is Fernstone Retreat. It's freaking beautiful here. We are going to light this bad boy up. Look at that. All right, guys, so we just arrived at Fernstone Retreat here in Farmington, Pennsylvania. I got some clips of the venue, which is, I think they call it the tree house. It's really freaking cool. Our uplighting is gonna look really cool in there tomorrow. And this is where we will be staying. Jerry and I just brought in some of our stuff, like our uplights, some of our ceremony gear,
our wireless microphone. We're going to get some stuff charged really quickly tonight. So that way we have it all juiced up for tomorrow. And I'm freaking excited. This place is beautiful. They were telling me that it can house about 60 guests. And you can kind of see, this is outside of our room. And yes, this does lock. It is locked. But there is literally bunk beds going all the way down there. It's freaking amazing. We're gonna go ahead and get some of our stuff charged up and get ready for tomorrow. We'll catch up with you guys in a little bit. All right, so we are getting ready to set up here at the Fernstone Retreat. And you can kind of see, they did an immaculate job with these tables. Wow. So we're gonna start bringing some of our stuff in. I love the lights that they have on the tree there. We are going to be setting up in this corner. And then we're gonna set up some wash effects, some up lights around the middle of this pavilion to really light it up. All right, so we got the main system all set up inside of here. And this is what we've got. There has been a little bit of a change for the ceremony. So Andrew's roommate, Colin, is going to be playing guitar for the ceremony itself. But he has an effects board and he has a Bose speaker that he brought. The original game plan was that he was just going to patch into my system. But because he has all of his stuff set up, he's a lot more familiar with this stuff. He would feel a lot better just using his system. So we are going to have his Bose, it sounds like a Bose column array that he is bringing. I'm not sure if it's the L1 Pro. I don't know exactly which one it is. It's Bose, so it's quality, we know that. He's gonna be using that, and then after he is done playing for the ceremony, the wedding party music, music as Madeline is walking down, he's gonna finish up, and then he's gonna jump in line with the wedding party. What we have decided to do, let me give you the quick tour. So it's a typical system you guys are used to seeing. We're gonna set our moving heads right here. Now, we brought our ZLXs, because as I've mentioned in past gig logs, the K12s are awesome speakers, but they don't have enough low end when you are running them by themselves. We did use our standard non-hydraulic tripod stands. We usually use these for ceremonies. But the reason I wanted to use them back here tonight is because in order to travel light, one thing that we did give up were my Ultimate Stands tall tripods. So I have the Ultimate Support Stands, the, I think, T900 or T99 or T100, the really tall guys. Because we were traveling 9 hours away to Pennsylvania, I did not bring those. So we just brought these and our ceremony tripod stands. So what we are going to do, because my thought is we will set one of our wash effects here. We're gonna elevate it, move it up, and then wash that whole ceiling and the top of the tree. And then we're gonna set another one on that side, doing the same thing, and we're gonna have one up light here on this side and then one up light here on this side. These Ultimate Support Stands have the wider tubing on them that those tripods do not. So the O-clamp that I use for my wash effects actually don't attach to those tripods over there. So that's why we are opting not to use these in our standard system, which is kind of a bummer. I do prefer these tripods over those ones. And if I was actually thinking about it, I should have, because I have two other tripods of these at my house, I should have just swapped these out for those two tripods. Hindsight is 20/20. It's okay for us to just run these. It looks really good. It looks clean. And then we are going to get one of the wash effects set up, and then we're going to use the other tripod for the ceremony when we head out there. They've already got the chairs all set up. So we're looking good. I mean, it is, so it's about 2:20 right now. Ceremony begins at 5 o'clock with the guests arriving at 4:30. So we are way ahead of schedule. It definitely helps that we stayed here last night. We spent all yesterday driving to get here. And then when we leave tomorrow morning, we're gonna do the same thing on the way back home. So we're gonna finish getting set up in here. I am currently undecided if I wanna use a scrim on these tripods or if I just want to run them bareback.
That's what she said.
Oh, that sounded not right. We'll figure it out. We are rocking the Prime 2 DJ controller, which is connected to Virtual DJ. After the ceremony, I'm gonna be repositioning my iPad Pro over here for the MyDMX Go that we are going to use to control the lighting. So we'll have up lights around the middle and then lighting up that tree. Just a little pro tip, when you are at a venue and you are staying at the venue, be mindful of where you put your clipboard with your planning files.
A few moments later.
All right, so we've got my clipboard. We've got the system set up for the ceremony here. So now we are just waiting for the guests to arrive so we can begin celebrating here at Fernstone Retreat in Farmington, Pennsylvania. It is honestly just insane to me that I'm even here right now DJing a wedding. I'm a little cold. Jerry's been making fun of me because for those of you that don't know me, I actually grew up in Okinawa, Japan, which for any of you that know where that is, it is very close to the equator on a tropical island in Japan, and I get cold very easily. Just a few minutes ago, I was wearing this, my jacket, and my outer coat because I was too cold. So, I think it's okay. So this is a speaker that Colin is going to be using. It is a Bose L1 Compact. It's a great speaker, so I'm not going to fault him for wanting to use that over my JBL Eon Compact 1. Although I did have to provide him a jackery to be able to power it, because there's no power out here.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dennis Johnson, and I'm Madeline's grandfather. I'm also known as Poppy, Pops, or just plain old Pop.
Editing this gig log, and boy was this event amazing. And it was just such a unique experience, and obviously with it being my first gig kind of away from home, if you will, there was a lot of anxiety leading up to the event. Howie Darkstar was gracious enough to invite me to the DJ NTV chill room, and we actually made a topic out of it because there were a couple other DJs in there that have done quite a few travel events and had some good advice for me. And one of those was the importance of backup. And although I always bring backup with me to an event, here it was even more important, right? So my philosophy was kind of having a 2-to-1 ratio, right? So there's one piece of crucial gear that I have. I need to have two backups for it. So the MacBook Pro is my main DJ laptop that I use, along with the iPad Pro that I use for the ceremonies and that I use for the MyDMX Go. Leading up to the event, I cloned the hard drive from the MacBook Pro onto my Windows laptop,
And then I also mirrored the iPad Pro to the Samsung Tab S7. So if I needed to switch my MacBook Pro for the Windows laptop, I could. And if I needed to switch the iPad Pro to the Samsung Tab S7, I could. Another thing that I did was back up the entire hard drive on my main laptop onto two external hard drives. So the MacBook Pro had a external SSD. It was a Samsung T7 Shield that had all of my current music on it, all of my entire music library. And the Windows laptop had an external mechanical drive. And then another thing that I did was I mirrored my hard drive on my MacBook Pro to my Engine OS. And what that allowed me to do was leverage the 2 terabyte SSD that I have installed into the Prime 2. I knew that we only had about 80 people, so it wasn't that big of an event. So I knew that if one of the ZLXs were to go, either the Mackie Thump Go or the JBL Eon Compact 1 or both of them would be able to do the job that we needed it to do. And that was actually why I brought both of them, even though I knew I was only going to need one of them. One of the things that I thought was really unique with this experience was just the venue itself. The venue was just so phenomenal, and it really allowed us a unique opportunity to experiment with the lighting, right? And the wash effects are perfect for this. I see a lot of DJs that have the wash effects, and oftentimes they'll use them as a dance floor wash light. They'll just put it behind them or in front of them, and then they'll just aim it at the dance floor. And although they are great for that, I think that if you aren't at least looking for unique lighting opportunities, then you're kind of handicapping the wash effects. So as an example, that tree looked phenomenal, and it really gave us a unique opportunity to not use the wash effects as a dance floor wash light, but instead use it to wash the top of the tree, because we had the uplighting at the base of the tree. And putting the wash effects aimed at the top of the tree, the dance floor was getting a lot of that wash coming down off of the tree. But when you looked inside of that venue, it looked phenomenal. The videos don't do it justice. The pictures I posted on social media don't do it any justice. It looked phenomenal. It was bright. It was vibrant, especially with pastel colors like the purple and the blues and the greens. It was phenomenal. And I really think that's where the wash effects really shine, is finding those unique opportunities. And I do have a lot of gig logs that are going to be coming out soon. And you'll see a lot of that because a lot of times when we use the wash effects, we still use them to wash the dance floor from time to time. But we mainly do that if there's not really anything to accent like the top of that tree. Because if there is a place that we just think would look phenomenal with that lighting, those wash effects do such a phenomenal job. That's it for this video. If you like this type of content, hit that like button, turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my future videos. And if you are interested in growing your DJ business, click the link in the description below to join our Facebook community, DJ Marketing School, where I am doing interviews with different DJs and industry experts and figuring out what works for growing our business. With the wedding season slowing down, you're going to be seeing a lot of new content coming out on the channel, from gear reviews, access gig logs that I haven't had a time to edit, to marketing tips. I'm also going to be converting the DJ Marketing School interviews into a podcast. So keep an eye out for that, as well as launching a new website for the DJ Marketing School, djmarketingschool.com, where all of that content will live and you'll be able to find it all in one place, along with additional marketing tips and tricks and resources. So keep an eye out for that. And if you want to be notified first, either subscribe to the channel or join our Facebook community using the link in the description. That's it for this video. We'll catch you guys in the next one.